Hello everyone. Today's topic is Daniel Stern, an American psychiatrist and psychoanalytic theorist, specializing in infant development, on which he had written a number of books, most notably The Interpersonal World of the Infant, 1985. So, he's next in line to talk about concerning personality disorders. In his book, Personality Disorders, James Masterson draws upon three main theorists and researchers in infant development, mainly pertaining to the development of the personality, and one I already talked about was Margaret Mahler. You may recall she coined the terms normal autistic and symbiotic phases that the infant goes through as they grow and develop, as well as the rapprochement crisis and the establishment of object permanence. In contrast, Stern finds no evidence of the autistic and symbiotic phases and talks more the infant's innate will towards independence. As I talk about him further, you'll see the contrast with Mahler and also note his move towards neurobiology as catalysts in child development. Stern's conceptualization based on psychoanalytic theory and research created a bridge of developmental models. He talks about development in overlapping layers or a series of interdependent stages. You have six layers. The emergent self, 0 to 2 months. The core self at 2 to 6 months. The subjective self around 7 to 15 months. And the verbal self. First, the emergent self gains a sense of physical cohesiveness, bond or connection. Second, at the core self the infant gains enough experience to organize a subjective experience. Here the mother is a self-regulating other for the infant. Third, is the intersubjective self where there is an exchange in effect with the mother. This effect exchange goes on to a theme and variation format or purposeful misattunements. Where in psychological terms attunement to ourselves is being aware with caring intent of our bodies, minds and spirits and or, focusing with caring intent on someone else's body mind, and spirit. So, basically a sort of mindfulness. Whereas, purposeful misattunement would be adjustments made by the mother to increase or decrease the infant's states of arousal. Fourthly, during the second year of life, giving rise to the verbal self, provides for a whole new domain of relatedness. This is said to move relatedness into the impersonal. 15 years later, Stern would add two more layers to the hierarchy of the self. The core self coming before the subjective self, and the narrative self developing out of the verbal self. Other key concepts would be motherhood constellation, where the mother's instinctual devotion and protection of her infant is crucial in the infant's development. And the proto-narrative envelope, basically this is memory without words or symbols. In other words, a plot visible through the perceptual, affective, and motoric lens. He goes on to state that early mother-child experiences have a beginning, middle, and an end with dramatic tension in between. These tiny narratives are proto-narratives. There is also the proto-narrative envelope that therapists use as an opportunity to correct faulty or false narratives. This basically means the area of pre-language. Looking at Stern's research, he proposes 11 assumptions. 1. The infant is pre-designed to be perceptually different from birth. 2. The infant is a co-creator of their development from the beginning. 3. Contrary to Mahler's work, there is no autistic and symbiotic phases. 4. Self, and self-regulating object, mother, run parallel from the beginning. 5. Orality is not a specific vehicle for internalization. This runs contrary to Freud's oral phase of development. Stern states that all perceptive modes participate in development. 6. A simultaneous dialectic evolved from the beginning of life. Again, this theory runs counter to Freud's pleasure and reality principles. 7. Basic domains of human connection evolve from the infant's active constructions of representations of interactions with self-regulating others. 8. There are four senses of self: emergent, core, intersubjective, and verbal. 9. These senses of self are primary organizers. There are sensitive periods, but all remain throughout life. 10. The sharing of mental states or attunements are crucial to the growth of the self. 11. Selective attunement potentially shapes the child's development and intrapsychic life. In other words, the child is just like one or the other parent. Stern, in his work, also emphasizes a child's autonomy and that his or her will is present at birth, thus challenging psychoanalytic theory. He goes on to say that it's everyday small moments that shape a child's personality rather than dramatic events during developmental stages. As an infant of about 4 months averts his or her eyes, to 12 months walking, to 15 months saying no, are acts of will in the natural development of the nervous system. Development can be thrown off track, however, by parents or other adults whose needs interfere with the child's natural urge for independence. But, he emphasized that this happens, continually, over time, and not in single, dramatic events. With attunements, he says, start the lifelong social relationships. When the baby starts to develop the subjective self, aspects of the child's personality begins to emerge around 8 months. You really begin to see problems in development when a parent continually fails to match the baby in effect. For example, you may acknowledge that Junior threw a ball, but fail to match the child's excitement. Showing that you know they did a thing, is not the same as validating their experience, if that makes sense, I hope. However, the psychological imprints of these early encounters are not written in stone of your working model of relationships. An imbalance at one point can be corrected later. Furthermore, there is no crucial period early in life that can mess you up forever. Basically, your personality is shaped early on, but remains fluid and changeable throughout a lifetime, and there is no single crisis in childhood that is the source of psychological problem in adulthood. So, there you have Stern in a nutshell. Is he controversial? Yep. In fact, so much so, it was predicted he would change the view of child development and psychoanalysis, and it did. He was certainly important enough to be talked about in Masterson's book Personality Disorders, where he goes on to explain the diagnosis and treatment of borderlines and narcissists. The next video will be on Dr. N.A. Shore from the world of neurobiology, and once he's talked about, I get to dive into the work of James Masterson. Fascinating stuff, huh? Well, I hope this information helped enlighten you as to the theories and stages of development of personality, how it's formed, and where something might go wrong. I know for me it helps me to put proper terms in their place and understand what professionals are really talking about, and what school of theory they're coming from. As for Stern, his work is based on meticulous research, and to me anyway, takes a common sense approach. I hope everyone is doing fabulously, living peace of mind narc-free. I know I am.